Hello everyone, my name is Stephanie and I'm the campus recruitment manager for Justin-Siena High School. It is very nice to have you here and to present our Justin-Siena High School. Our topic today is Be Ready to Be Brave at Justin-Siena, and it's going to be a student panel. We have amazing student ambassadors here sharing their stories and sharing stories about like what can newcomer students to expect as the new semester begins. So this is our table of content. In this session, we'll be talk about like what to expect in general as a newcomer students, and what does newcomer students to expect on academics, on sports, extracurriculars, and also we have an international student sharing his experience and perspective of what to expect and how to prepare it to be a successful, have a successful beginning. And we will leave the Q&A at the end of the session, so be sure to put in your questions in the chat box and we'll be able to get it by the end of the meeting. So let's take this chance to meet our student ambassadors. First, Juan, can you introduce yourself to everyone here?
Hi, everyone. My name is Juan Honorio Puentes Ramirez, and I'm a sophomore here at Justin-Siena.
Thank you. Andy?
Hello, everyone. I'm Andy. I'm an international student at Justin-Siena. I'm also a sophomore.
Olivia?
Hello, everybody. My name is Olivia Valleca, and I'm a sophomore at Justin as well. It's nice to meet everybody, and I'm really excited to talk to you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for taking the valuable Friday night time with us and sharing your experience at Justin-Siena. So before the students sharing, I want to kind of talk about what can newcomer students to expect in general. So first, when you arrive to the school in United States, you need to know where the school is located. So for example, Justin-Siena High School is located in Northern California, and it actually has a lot of great universities around it, like UC Berkeley, like Stanford. And it's also very convenient on the transportation. We have two major international airports located very close to the school. So the student doesn't need to take like transits. It's going to be a very easy transportation from their home abroad. And there are many Fortune 500 companies located in here. So their students will find it easy to find an internship as well. And what do you also need to know about your school is the school information. Definitely, you want to check on your school website and you need to know your school address. Justin-Siena is actually a Nishi ranked A+ school, and the school was founded in 1966. So it has a rich history. The school has 40 acres and it offers grade 9 to 12, and it's a co-ed school. So these are some basic information that you definitely need to know before you come here to the United States. And besides the school information, you also need to know your dorm, where you're gonna live. At Justin-Siena, we have an on-campus residence. So you'll be live right on the campus at school, and you will know that you have a very safe environment to live with. There are police department, fire department that is very close to the school, and you will need to know like your living condition, if it's a single bed or it's a double bed, and does the school, like on the dorm, does it have a swimming pool, and what is the study room looks like, and is there any athletic facilities in the dorm? So all of these are something that you need to know before you come here to the United States, and this is what it looks like at Justin-Siena. And it's also important to know that you have an amazing chef that will be taking care of what you're going to eat at the school. So besides this general information, it's also important to know like about academics. So what do you expect on academics? We will have Olivia to share with everyone how and what to expect for academics. Olivia?
Hello, everybody. Once again, my name is Olivia. Ms. Sun, are you going to screen share the slideshow? You're on mute, Ms. Sun.
Oh, can you see my screen now?
No, maybe it's because of the background.
Andy, can you see my screen?
Yes, I can.
Oh. Mm. Oh, yes, now I can. Thank you. Okay. Hold on. Okay. Sorry. So I'm going to be talking a little bit about academics here at Justin-Siena. I'm going to go over some major points that I feel like sort of highlight on what you should expect as a student at Justin-Siena. So I'm going to start by talking about calendars, then the student handbook, course catalogs, graduation requirements to help you understand your classes. I'm going to introduce you to your counselors, and then I'm going to show you some useful apps that you use here in your time at Justin. Okay, so starting off with calendars. So this is the 2021 school calendar. We start school around late August and end in early June. We have a couple of breaks, Thanksgiving, winter, and spring breaks. These breaks basically mean that you're not going to school. You might still have sports practice. So this is just pretty much kind of yearly. And then so another calendar that you'll be provided with as a student is your calendar on Schoology. This is a more specific calendar tailored to you as a student. So here you'll be able to see all the assignments that you need to get done, anything academic going on in your school day. Here on the right, you can see a daily calendar. This is an example of mine. It shows what homework I have due, what tests I might have that day, or quizzes. On the left, you can see what kind of homework and what kind of events are happening academically on a monthly basis. So next slide, I'll be talking about student handbooks. So the student handbook is kind of your go-to guide as a new student at Justin-Siena. I've linked a picture of the table of contents here so you can kind of see it talks about student life, academic life, your code of conduct. So I've also included a picture of the schedule you get as a Justin student. So as a Justin student, you start school at 9 a.m., which is a great time to start. You've gotten a good amount of sleep and you're ready to start the day. And then you get about a 10-minute break to go in between your classes. One special thing about Justin-Siena and their schedule is you get something called a community period, which is a time that you get to interact with your teachers and get any work done. So that way you might not have as much homework and you can go for guidance, talk to your peers and your teachers. And then you either have 3 periods in a day if it's an A day, and 4 periods in a day if it's a B day. And we ended around 3:10. And then to the right, sorry, Ms. Sun, could you go back? Thank you. Is the code of conduct. Basically, this kind of goes over academic integrity and what's expected of you as a Justin student, the kind of like discipline that you're expected to have. And this has gone over in your first year at Justin. So next we have the course catalog. So when you're a new student at Justin, this is how you pick your classes and it's how you pick your classes every year. To the right, you can see the different kinds of classes you could take, a regular class, an honors class, an AP class, which I'll go over in more detail in the next few slides. You can see here that in the table of contents for the course catalogs, it goes over all the kinds of classes you take at Justin, some examples being mathematics, science, social studies, and world languages. So next I want to talk about the AP honors and notable courses. The difference between college prep, honors, and AP is that college prep is the basic level of classes. These satisfy the graduation and college entrance requirements. Honors are a little bit above college prep courses. They're a little bit more rigorous and the classes go in depth a little bit more. This is the kind of class you would take if you're interested in. This becomes available to you as soon as your freshman year. The next step up from an honors class would be an AP class, which are offered to you starting your sophomore year. This is basically college level work, and at some colleges it even counts as a class and you don't have to take that class in college. These are the kind of classes you take when you're really interested in the subject, and at the end of the year you take an AP exam, which you've been studying for all year. The teachers at Justin do a really good job of preparing you for these rigorous exams. The final one is called a dual credit class, which you can talk to your counselor about. It's taking a class at a college, and you get the credit for college and the credit for high school. So Ms. Sun, could you go back a couple of slides to the AP honors and notable courses? Thank you. So these are kind of some of the honors and APs offered at Justin. You can see there's a very wide range. Justin-Siena does a really good job in offering really high level courses for its students. A lot of students take these. And then some notable courses that they have are engineering, computer science principles, and theater. Justin-Siena has a good theater program, which we'll be going over later. And then next, these are the graduation requirements. So there's a certain amount of classes that you have to take each year to be able to graduate. For example, you can see that you need 4 years of English, but there's some classes that you only need to take 1 year of, for example, a visual or performing art. Depending on your interest, you can take more than one of these, but it's not required to graduate. These graduation requirements kind of give you a sense of how you need to schedule out your classes. And of course, you are not expected to do this on your own. Your counselor will help you. So this is a really smooth process, but this just kind of gives you an idea of what you need to be taking. And then, so another thing that I really want to talk about is the counselor program at Justin. This really is an exceptional program that we have here. We have three counselors here at Justin-Siena, three counselors for about 500 to 600 students compared to the average public school, which has one counselor for 1,000 to 2,000 students. These counselors are something that you know will help you with your academic scheduling. Whenever you have a problem at Justin or need to talk to someone, if you're ever confused about something, these are the people you go to. And in addition to those counselors, we have college counselors. And these are the counselors you get to know your junior and senior year. They help you prepare your college resume. They help you figure out what college you want to go to and how to be on the correct path to get to a really prestigious college if that's what you're looking for. And you can see on the bottom, there's a quote from one of our counselors there. They really emphasize how much they teach our students confidence, resilience, and self-advocacy. So then the last thing that I wanted to talk to you about were some useful apps here at Justin-Siena. So the first one is PowerSchool. This is where you can expect to find your grades, your final grades. It tells you about your attendance. This is something that you really want to focus on and kind of have on hand. The second one is Schoology. I would say this is the primary app that you use. It tells you when your assignments are due, where all your assignments are located. It gives you helpful stuff like calendars, and it allows you to have a way to contact your teachers. And then the other couple of apps that you use to get assignments done and homework done are called Notability and Genius Scan. Notability is an app where you can import your notes and or an assignment, and you can do these assignments online. Many assignments at Justin-Siena are online. There's not that many paper assignments, and these allow you to complete all your assignments through the iPad you're given at the beginning of your freshman year, and you have throughout all 4 years. And then finally, Genius Scan is a PDF scanner. If you are, say, given a paper assignment and you want to submit it to Schoology, you would use Genius Scan. You would take a picture of it and submit it to Schoology. Once you get into Schoology for each of your classes, there will be lots of resources that show you how to use Genius Scan. They provide videos on how to import assignments and then put them back into Schoology, how to use Notability. So Schoology is full of resources on how to use all of these apps. This is kind of just a brief overview on their purpose.
Thank you so much, Olivia. Thanks for sharing all these useful resources to us. And I believe that with all this kind of basic knowledge on hands, and the newcomers will be able to prepare for a very successful beginning of the semester on academics. So next, we will be having Juan to talk about and share with us what to expect on sports and extracurriculars, since everybody will be interested in this on the extra academic hours. So how should you take advantage of this time? And Juan?
Hi, everyone. So yes, so Olivia just finished talking about academics, which is a huge part of the high school experience. But if you have interest in high school sports and or extracurriculars, I'm here to talk to you today about them. So a typical high school sports team has around 15 to 20 players, depending on the size of the school or the popularity of the sport. And it can, of course, be bigger or smaller. It just all depends. There are junior varsity and varsity players. So the varsity team is the main team, which are kind of the top players, the ones who are more experienced, typically upperclassmen, whereas the junior varsity are the junior varsity players are members of a team who are not the main players of the team, but they are usually underclassmen, like freshmen and sophomores, or inexperienced players who haven't played the sport before. So team captains, there's either one or two players that are voted by the team as the leader. They can lead practices, call plays, but will always be under the leadership and supervision of the coach. The starters are the best of the bunch, the ones who will start the game. So they're kind of the most experienced, who know the game the best and play the best, who will go out and start the game almost every single time. So in terms of sports, there are three seasons of a sport. So fall, which ranges from August until November, sports include football, water polo, golf, cross country, volleyball. Whereas in the winter, which lasts from November until March, the typical winter sports include basketball, soccer, and wrestling. And spring, which is March until May, the typical spring sports are baseball, swimming, diving, track and field, tennis, and lacrosse. So there is girls' sports and boys' sports teams. So for almost every single one of our sports, there is a boys team and a girls team with both a varsity and junior varsity for each one. So if you're female, you'd be competing against other female teams, whereas if you're male, you'll be competing against other male teams. However, certain sports like track and swimming are co-ed, so both genders will be together competing against other mixed gender schools. And the tryout process for this varies. It all depends, of course, if you want to try out for the sport or if you're not sure. Again, like Olivia mentioned, your counselor is the first place to go, or email Miss Sarah Goble, which is our athletic director of the whole school. So really, if you want to join a sport, you don't have to be super experienced at all. I highly recommend it. It's a lot of fun. So the typical day of a student athlete, so morning practices range from either from sometime around 6 a.m. all the way up until the latest being 8:30 a.m., with the typical practice being about 1 to 2 hours, and the time range is between 3:30 p.m. and 8 p.m. after school. There's games about every week once the competition season starts, but of course there's a 4-week preseason workouts and conditioning that you do, and these games often require early dismissal. So one thing to keep in mind about being a student athlete is it is a big commitment. You are a student first and an athlete second, so it's really a tough balance to kind of keep both the student and the athlete side in, just because it requires hours of motivation and dedication to both things individually. But it is something really fun, and I highly recommend doing it. So Justin-Siena offers a stellar athletics program with 45 different athletic teams, including regionally competitive varsity teams. The golf team is especially popular with our international students. So we have baseball, basketball, cheerleading, cross country, fencing, football, golf, lacrosse, soccer, softball, tennis, track, volleyball, water polo, and wrestling. And we have a total of 144 league championships with 59 section championships and 20 state awards. So the highlight sport is golf, the Justin-Siena boys and girls golf team. The NorCal state champions by the boys were in 1994, 1995, and 1998. With the NCS champion, they were the NCS champions, the Scholastic champions in 2006. They had a lot of league championships, both boys and girls. Right here, you can see Dominic, who's a skilled golfer and cites 4 years of golf matches at his favorite memory at Justin-Siena. He is grateful for his relationships with Coach Ray Graziani, who has been leading the golf program for the past few years, and Dominic now studies computer science at Columbia University. So this is another highlight sport, which is swimming. So the program philosophy is Justin-Siena Swim provides athletes with an opportunity to develop physical ability, good sportsmanship, healthy coping mechanisms, and life skills. We ask for a commitment to the team while honing individual prowess and positive competitive environment that caters to all levels of swimmers. Swimmers are guided by coaching staff to the best of their ability. So I personally do swim and water polo. And so for water polo, we would have morning practice from about 7:30 to 8:30 a.m. in the morning, and then do evening practices from 6 to 8 p.m. But for swim, we only do evening practices, which range from about 5 to 7 p.m., with our meets often requiring us to leave school early sometimes. So these are a couple images of our team. This one's very recent on the bottom left-hand corner. This was just a couple weeks ago. Even Olivia's in that photo. So yeah, we have a lot of fun. Another highlighted sport would be wrestling. So Coach Caducci brought his 23 years as a coach to Justin-Siena and is heading into his seventh season at Justin-Siena, coming off of one of the most successful seasons in recent memory in 2019 to 2020. The team placed an impressive third in the NCS Division III duels meet and had several strong team and individual showings along the way. The Justin-Siena wrestling team was the 2006 NCS champions. This is another highlight sport, which is very, very popular, which is football. So the NCS Division V championships, 1983, 2000, 2003, 2004, 2008, 2012, and 2014, with league championships in 1973, 1974, 1979, 1983, and 2004. And a lot of scholastic championships. Coach Brandon LaRocco, which was the class of 1998, will be in his eighth season as our head varsity football coach at Justin-Siena. In 2019, the team made the NCS semifinals and finished with an 8-4 record overall. This is just a video of our football team in case you guys wanted to see it. They have a lot of fun. It's a great team bonding exercise, and everyone goes to the games to go and support. And it's one of the highlights of personally my high school experience thus far. Next, here you can see some of our facilities. We have three different baseball fields, one for baseball, varsity and JV baseball, as well as girls softball. In the right-hand corner, you can see Clark Gym, where sports like volleyball and basketball are played. It's newly remodeled. Everything is brand new in it. It's amazing. And then on the bottom right-hand corner, you can see a bit of Dodd Stadium, which is where the football team and the lacrosse teams and track and field teams practice and compete. And then finally, we have our tennis courts right there, which are right next to our school. So in terms of clubs at Justin-Siena, there is a club fair, which is an annual event that happens around the beginning of every school year, where all our different clubs on campus come together and set up booths with information on what the club is about and how to join. And what a lot of students don't know is that if you have an interest that isn't already showcased at a club at Justin-Siena, you could even start your own club. But some of the highlighted clubs that I'm going to talk to you about include mock trial, which both Olivia and I are participate in. There's robotics club and environmental club and outdoors club. So, but personally, my favorite club that I'm a part of would have to be comedy sports. Comedy sports is a high school league where students get together and learn a variety of different improv games and perform them for audiences to watch. It's a fantastic way to meet other students and feel more confident. And as Mr. Bailey, the head of the arts department at Justin-Siena, would say, turn your sexy switch on. It really just helps you build confidence and perform together and not be afraid to be silly. So mock trial, Justin-Siena offers a highly competitive mock trial team. Mock trial is a nationwide activity in which each school has the same set of facts and a law case in which to work on. So the teams then present a fully realized trial in a real court before a real judge. Each school has a prosecution and defense team, which alternate in weekly trials. Justin-Siena's mock trial team is now ranked number 19 in the entire state of California with over 400 teams. The team has won the Napa County competition for the past 6 years in a row, where we have competed against teams from 35 different counties. The advantages of the program: the mock trial program was created to help students acquire a working knowledge of the U.S. judicial system, develop analytical abilities and communication skills, and gain an understanding of their obligations and responsibilities as participating and members of society. Students involved at Justin-Siena's mock trial team have gone on to study at prestigious U.S. universities, including Columbia and Stanford. Alondra, a 2017 graduate who then graduated from Stanford class in 2021, credits mock trial for her own personal development during high school, saying, "Not only did I learn about law, but I became more confident and inspired as a person." This is a video highlighting our robotics team. Our robotics program, where Mr. Fiddler is the head of science. I don't think it's gonna load right now, but definitely we could try and make it load later. So we'll just move on to the next slide.
Sorry about that. Let me try playing from here.
Yes. No worries.
Yeah, in this video's link later in the chat box so everyone can see it.
Yeah.
In this video, we'll be able to see Mr. Fiddler guiding us through the robotics classroom and giving us a tour of the classroom.
Yeah, so that video, it'll be linked. It'll include just basically an overview and tour of Project Lead the Way and our different robotics teams. And so if you're someone who's very interested in science and STEM, I highly recommend watching that video. Some extracurriculars that you could join include the California Scholarship Federation, French Club, Comedy Sports, Friday Night Live Club, Students for Change, Spirit Club, Key Club, Mock Trial, National Arts Honor Society, Ping Pong Club, Spanish Club, even. So all these clubs kind of centralize and strengthen our Justin-Siena community, because all these clubs find ways to give back to the community. So Friday Night Live Club, which I'm a part of, we work on promoting safe drinking and no drinking or drug use for underage youth. And then Students for Change works in a variety of different ways representing our school. Spirit Club is a way to get of school spirit, where we'll all go to each other's games and support each other. So then something that Justin-Siena also provides is student ambassadors. So if you're a student ambassador, if you wish to be one, especially you being international students, once you gain a more understanding of the school and get to know it better, you could actually represent the school and give tours and do a bunch of different activities. Just a great way to get that involved. You can even run for student council, which I am a part of. You'd be essentially representing one of six representatives for your class and making major decisions at our school, planning dances and a lot of student activities and so much more. So yeah, that was my coverage on kind of the sports and extracurriculars. We do have a great arts program and dance. If that's something you're interested in, I can answer more questions about that at the end, but that's it for me. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Juan. That gives us a great knowledge on the sports and the extracurriculars. And if the students, when they come here and want to enjoy and participate, they know where to go to and how they can start. Definitely taking part in the sport and the extracurriculars and the clubs is very important, so you can get more adapted to the new environment, and it really helps you a lot. So we will have one international student here, and Andy, he will be able to share with us as an international student, what to expect to, you can successfully start your semester here in the United States. So Andy?
Yeah, hello everyone again. My name is Andy, and I'm currently an international student at Justin-Siena. I'm a sophomore, but it is actually my first year to be physically at this campus due to COVID last year. Today, I'm going to introduce you how we can be successful at being in an American high school as an international student. And these are all that you need to know about American high school. You need to get socialized. When you have any problems or confusions, we have support for academic, social, or emotional. You need to learn your teachers' names and ask questions frequently. You need to learn your schedule and get a planner so that your high school life will be more organized. To get socialized, you can prepare an interesting self-introduction to make your schoolmates have a deep first impression on you. For example, because of my visa problem, I arrived late last year, so I missed 2 weeks of school. But when I introduced myself in the first class, I called myself the late one to let them know me faster. Then I went to orientation. It is highly recommended to go to orientation because it is really helpful to have a first sight of your future teachers and schoolmates. It is also a platform to make friends quickly. As international students whose English is not their first language, an effective way to improve your oral English is to talk to classmates. By making friends with them, you can share your experiences in your own countries with one another, or you can help one another in academic problems. When leaving our dorm, Amerigo provides excellent trips during spring break and Thanksgiving break. Last year, during Thanksgiving break, I went to Los Angeles with all the international students and many staffs. There, I visited Santa Monica Beach, which is a pretty famous beach in California. A Six Flags Magic Hill, which is a famous amusement park in America. And also UCLA is a good university, very famous university, no matter in America or across the world. During the spring break, I visited San Francisco to see the Golden Gate Bridge by ship. It is pretty beautiful, although it is kind of raining, so I didn't take a very clear picture, but it's another kind of beauty. I also visited the Chinatown there, which is the biggest Chinatown in America. Besides these trips, we also have activities on weekends, like going skating, playing golf, or private movies, etc. In the dorm, we usually use a social media site called WeChat to communicate with one another or post announcements. So check it regularly to make you won't miss anything. At Justin-Siena, we have a lot of supportive people who are caring about us. We have school counselors, which is a really nice group of people. We can talk to them if we have any questions about everything around the school, like academic aspects or some confusion about your course selection, something like that. Besides, we also have counselors from Amerigo staff who will check with you regularly to make sure everything is good. As an international student, my home is almost on the opposite side of the earth. I'm from China. So sometimes I will feel homesick. However, I can make a call or video with my parents because today's internet is very convenient. We have many social medias that can support us to chat with our parents. Other ways to release nerves, like making friends here, which can make you feel happy by sharing common interests, finding your passion to stay positive, or finding a favorite place. For me, I like coffee shop, especially because I enjoy sitting in a silent environment and drinking coffee by my own. Next is a tip about the different ways of calling teachers. In the beginning, I usually call my teachers teacher, because in my hometown, we usually call our teachers just teacher. However, the way students call their teachers is actually different in America. Here, we call male teachers Mr. as a prefix plus the teacher's last name. And we call female teachers Mrs. or Miss plus the last name of the teacher. For the teachers who have doctor degree, we can also call them doctor plus the last name of the teacher. So you need to be familiar with teachers' names and show enough respect to them. When I was having classes at the beginning of this academic year, I usually confused due to my English skills, especially in my physics course. In that case, I told my physics teacher to move my place up front a little bit to understand the contents fully. I frequently ask classmates or teacher to, as long as they had time to solve it for me. But eventually I built a good relationship with everybody around me. I built a good relationship with the teacher and classmates, and I could understand him better. In American high school, we have a lot of spare time for students to do whatever they want. In that case, we need a daily schedule to manage ourselves and use time effectively. And here is my schedule for school days. Between 7 to 8 a.m., I woke up from bed and managed myself, including washing my face or brush my teeth. And during 8 to 8:50 a.m., I usually have breakfast and get everything ready for school, like manage my backpack and to prepare all the materials I want for today's school. On 8:55, I leave for school and the school begins at 9 a.m. So after a school day, we are dismissed every day at 3:10 p.m. During 3:10 to 4 p.m. is a relaxed time because I just released from a great school pressure. So I need a little bit relax. During this time, I can go to the club or playing sports or just hanging out outside, walk around, something like that. During 4 to 5:30 p.m. is my first study period. I usually finish all of my school homework during this period. And during 5:30 to 6 p.m., I have a 30-minute break. And then usually during 6 to 7 p.m., our dinner is ready. So I will have dinner cooked by our private chef in the dorm. And during 7 to 8:30 p.m. is my second study period. During 8:30 to 9 p.m. Is also a 30-minute break. And 9 to 10:30 p.m. is my third study period. During these two study periods, I usually studied something by myself, like online courses or some other knowledges. And last, during 10:30 to 11 p.m., I usually manage myself, like getting a shower, getting my teeth brushed, and then go to bed. So, besides the daily schedule, during the school day, we also have an app called Power School, which is Olivia introduced before. We have it to manage our day, school day courses. And here is what it looks like. We have A days, which include an advisory, and we have B days, which has four classes. And from here, we can see from the bottom.
I didn't get that. Could you try again?
For the top line, we can see Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday for the whole week, which day, and the course schedule. And then we have timeline, which is vertically. We can see the beginning time of the classes and the end time, and the blank during the classes are break time. And that's all about the school schedule. When studying high school, we need to have a goal to keep us motivated and to keep us have enough energy to get good grades. So it is important to get a planner. The goal can be a short-term goal, like making a new friends in this week, or get an A in the schoolwork, or winning a tennis game, or participating in the student club. It can also be a long-term goal, such as becoming a captain in the robotic team. I'm actually the captain of my robotic team, or getting accepted into your dream college. When it comes to college applications, last year we had many students who got offers from many famous universities, like Brown University, which is very good in literature, or Stanford University is famous across the world, Yale, Princeton, et cetera. So Justin-Siena provided a good guidance for college applications. If you wanna be brave, I look forward to see you join us. That's all about my part. Thank you.
Thank you, Andy. Thank you so much for sharing with your international student perspectives. And with that, I believe that international student newcomers, they will be able to benefit from how to adapt to a new environment. Now it's for our Q&A sessions. And just to let you know that if you have any questions, please just put in the chat box and we'll have our student ambassadors be able to share with you. So let me... I do have one quick question for Juan. So from what we see, we can tell you have a really good GPA of 4.67, which is amazing. Can you share with us a little bit how you get such a great GPA, and how did you balance your life with the academic and extracurricular? Because you participate in so many sports and clubs as well.
Yeah, so I think Andy's advice of a planner is great, because personally, I've been fortunate enough to be able to balance all the extracurriculars, which kind of take up most of my time after school. So just a month ago, I was going from musical rehearsal right after school to mock trial practice, then to swim practice, then to working on, then to water polo, then to working on my schoolwork. So definitely there's a lot of opportunities at school. So originally I was taking 7 courses, but I highly recommend taking only 6 so that you have a study hall. So a study hall throughout the day is a great thing to have in your schedule, because you can work on your homework and get it all done if you're someone like me who has a lot of different extracurriculars to do after school. So that's definitely something that I recommend. And just staying on top of your schoolwork and homework is a big thing. Just get your work done. I can't tell you how important it is. I promise it'll make it a lot easier. Keeping in contact with your teachers is a great way to stay connected and to make sure you understand everything, even asking for help. We have a great student tutoring program at the school. I myself am a student tutor for classes that I'm more helpful in, which would be world history or Spanish. For as I get help sometimes when I need classes in a class like Honors Algebra 2, which I struggle with. Definitely outreach for help if you need it. And there's always a way and opportunities to do a lot of different things if you're someone like me who's interested in a lot of different things that are outside of school. So yeah.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Juan. So Andy, another question for you is, I always know that you are a STEM person. So I think that is also why that you chose Justin-Siena to begin your academics, because of the school has a really good STEM engineering program. And what's your major, what do you see your college major? Do you already have something in mind that you want to pursue in your college?
Yeah, definitely. I already decided my college major. My college major is related to computer science, which is called artificial intelligence. And it is sort of combination of engineering and computer science. So that's why I chose Justin-Siena, because Justin-Siena have a 4-year track of engineering program called we associated with Project Lead the Way, which is a educational company that provides all 4 years track of engineering program project. In my engineering course, we learned the structures to build software, to build hardwares, and also we learned coding and building robot, something like robot or programming to make the software. So that's why I choose Justin-Siena, because yeah, it has a really good STEM atmosphere. Also in the robotic club, we have a good group of people and we have a good team. I really enjoy the time when we work together to build a robot and to fight for the game.
Sounds good. And I know that you are also taking summer classes, right? So can you also share with us how Amerigo teachers are supporting or helping you to get your summer courses?
Yeah, I have a counselor. His name is Mr. Chris. He often check with me regularly and to find some opportunities for me to develop my skill, because I'm pretty advanced in math. So Mr. Chris designed a future plan for me, and he found a lot of resources from college for me to improve my skill and to develop my computer science and math skill, which I need to use in the future study. This year summer school, I will take math courses from UC Berkeley, which is also found by Mr. Chris, and also he helped me a lot for the application part.
Awesome, thank you. And next question is for Olivia. So Olivia, can you maybe share with us, like, I know that you're handling with a lot of sports. You are participating in JV cheerleading, varsity wrestling, varsity swimming. How did you find your passion or your interest in these different kinds of sports?
Well, I think sports are a really crucial part of Justin-Siena because of the team that they provide. It's a really good way to meet people and also to gain qualities. You can easily become a leader in sports, and you learn a lot about communicating and collaborating with other people, which is important. It also teaches you what it means to be a part of a team, which I think is a really valuable aspect, and it's something that's really good to learn at in high school, and I think Justin-Siena does a great job at it. And the coaches and the teammates and the players at Justin are all really exceptional, kind of you wouldn't find it anywhere else.
Awesome. Thank you for sharing. Okay, let me stop sharing my screen and see if we got any more questions from the chat box and we can take it. Otherwise, that will be most of our sharing for today. And thank you again so much for joining us and take part in and hearing our students' ambassadors sharing their stories. So if we don't have any questions coming up, I'm going to just to share the one last video of the Mr. Fiddler's sharing the robotics class.
These are the parts.
With that, after that, I will be all our sharing for today's events. There we go.
So these are the parts for our robotics kit. Our sophomore year engineering class has a unit on robotics and programming and automation. So they get to build all kinds of physical contraptions with motors and sensors, and they wire them all together and write code to get them to do what they want. Over here, we have also a couple of 3D printers. So these are a couple of prints right now from our freshman class. So they do some CAD modeling, 3D modeling on the computer, and then they're able to actually print out their creations. We have also here, this is our large format printer with kind of a quick example of something that we might look at in like our civil engineering class with sort of a building plan and stuff. Those are kind of some of our main things.
Amazing. Thank you so much.
All right.
Thanks, Juan, for recording this video with Ms. Fiddler. So that'll be it for our session today. And thank you so much for joining. And thanks the student ambassador for sharing with us their valuable perspectives. And have a good night. Have a good day, everyone. Thank you.